Dear students and friends, welcome to my session on Learn Arduino. I'm Dr. M. Sandil Kumar. In today's program, we'll see about the linear actuator program, through that how we can operate and actuate the linear actuator. Now we'll see the particulars about this particular project. This linear actuator is capable of lifting a weight of 10 kg in our case actually. Now I'll show you the model. This is the linear actuator that I'll be using it. We'll see the specification of it. If we see the specification, the maximum stroke of this particular actuator is 100 mm. It can travel a distance of 100 mm at the maximum. It is operating at the voltage of 12 volt DC type. The speed at which moves the RAM, the speed is 40 millimeters per second. The thrust is very important here. The thrust for this particular actuator is 100 newtons. 100 newtons means roughly 10 kg. So this can lift a weight of 10 kg actually. Okay. So that is what is mentioned here. Here this has a speed of 40 mm per second and stroke of 10 millimeter. But actuators with the different speed and different strokes are available in the market. So you can buy as you wish. Using this Arduino Nano board, you can design a lifting platform even with a payload capacity of 100 kg also as well. Okay, now let us see the program. Before that, we'll see some more the parts required for this particular project. The parts required are, as usual, the Arduino Nano V3 board, a 12 volt DC power supply, a 12 volt DC linear actuator that I will be using, and to supply the power to this particular linear actuator, we require a 12 volt 10 amps SMPS power supply. And the fourth part that we require is a 4 channel high trigger relay board. This is very, very, very important. You should have a high trigger relay board. Otherwise, after making the connection as per this one, you just read it. I'll give you this as a PDF file available in the attachment, as the link in the attachment in the description. Okay, just read it and accordingly you can give the connection. But again, I'm telling you, you have to buy and use a 4 channel high trigger relay board only. Otherwise, if you use a low trigger, for example, that will end up with a short circuit. That may spoil the Arduino board, or that may spoil Arduino board, the relay board, and even the linear actuator also. Here, for getting the signal, I am using the line follower sensor. This is the connection for the line follower sensor. Okay. Now let us go to the program. So this is the program. I did not explain much about this particular program because it is a very simple and self-explanatory. Let me explain the key point of this particular program. Once the signal is received through the line follower sensor, the output switches 1 and 2 will be high. This will be high for 2.5 seconds because you see, if you see this specification, I am using a 100 mm linear actuator. Its speed is 40 millimeters per second. That means for every 1 second, it travels 40 mm. So for 100 mm, we require 2.5 seconds actually. Am I right? So 2.5 seconds timing I have to give. If suppose if it is 200 mm stroke, then naturally 5 seconds delay should be given to operate this one, okay? Or else, instead of 100 mm stroke, if you want only 50 mm stroke, then give a timing of 1.25 seconds. That is 1250 milliseconds only you have to give. If you give only 1250 milliseconds, it will travel only through a distance of 50 mm only, not the full 100 mm. So based on this only, you have to do some calculation. It is a very simple calculation, I am telling you. So since I am giving 2500 milliseconds, that means 2.5 seconds. After that, both the switches, both the relays must be switched off. So it has moved forward motion now. Okay. Then after that, there is a delay of 1 second. Then these 4-5 lines will make the it will make the actuators to traverse in the opposite direction. Okay. So for that, I will be using these 5 lines. Again, there is a delay of 0.5 second, then the program ends. So this is how it works. Again, we will go back to the part list. This is a linear actuator that I am using, right? Then it is a high trigger relay board. It is not a 4-channel high trigger relay board actually. Even it's a special relay board. You can set it as a low trigger or a high trigger by using those jumpers. Okay. Again, I am repeating, high trigger relay board is very, very important for this particular project. If you are not using this high trigger relay board, then the entire system will be collapsed and that will short circuit and the short circuit will happen and that will spoil all the components maybe. This is the setup. The power is on for both the Arduino and for the motor. Okay, now we'll see it in action. The program is fused. This is the program. The program is fused here. Okay, now we'll see that in action. Now line follower sensor is sensed here. Then it traverses 100 mm in the forward direction. After 1 second delay, 100 mm in the reverse motion. Second attempt, sensed 100 mm forward motion, 1 second delay, 100 mm reverse motion. Okay, so in between, if you want to stop it, then accordingly you have to change this value. You have to change this value. Okay, I have given a cushion of 200 milliseconds here, especially in the return stroke actually. Okay, so this is how you can using Arduino, you can write a program and to control the linear actuator. Okay, so that's all for this session. So subscribe my channel and inform this to other students and faculty members, so then they'll also gain some input through my session actually. Thank you so much.